Hi guys, we just read some horoscopes from Nuestra Gente. It's the Clasificados en Español, and it's from enero 18th of January 2018. Now I want to read some two more articles. This one, it's called Confidencias con Sofía, Quinceañera en Europa. It's an anonymous. So the pregunta, the question is, Sofía le escribo porque mi niña estará cumpliendo años este verano de 2018 y no quiso quinceañera. Desea un viaje a Europa, sería ella y su prima de 18, que aparte de primas son mejores amigas. Pero no sé, en la agencia dicen que se encargan de todo. Hay un itinerario, lugares para visitar. En fin, todo está controlado y manejado por la empresa en cuanto a guías, paseos y hospedaje. Solo tendrían que pagar y buscar lugares para comer, que desde luego también tienen recomendaciones. En fin, ¿cuál es su opinión al respecto? Y la respuesta es: siento un poco de presión con su pregunta, sobre todo porque no quiero que su hija se vaya a molestar con mi respuesta. Pero te la daré y será la más honesta posible. En lo personal, creo que el mundo no es el mismo de hace años. La tecnología y redes sociales han traído infinidades de ventajas, pero también problemas. Tras perfiles ficticios en redes sociales se esconde un gran número de seres con diversas maldades e intenciones. Nunca se sabe quién ve, lee el perfil de su hija, incluso si nadie lo lee o ve. Una vez que lleguen dos adolescentes completamente solas a Europa, es incierto. La chica de 18, por muy madura que sea e inteligente, no podrá con una responsabilidad que un padre o madre lleva 15 años tratando. Así que es el supuesto de que ambas chicas son muy maduras y juiciosas, quien le dice que alguien que conozcan en el transcurso del viaje, avión, aeropuerto, restaurante, lugar de turistas, hotel, etcétera. No solo no es maduro, sino malvado, sucio, perverso, y las convence de hacer algo divertido, un antro, drogas, fiesta privada, en fin. Yo moriría de la preocupación al saber que mi hija adolescente está en un país extranjero, sola, sorda, ciega y muda, porque incluso si van a España, Inglaterra, donde hablan idiomas que tu hija conoce, asumo el acento es diferente y no solo eso, la cultura es diferente. La forma en que los jóvenes se divierten, en fin, todo es diferente y ajeno. Así que si estuviésemos hablando de mi hija, ya, yo no la dejaba ir. Va toda la familia, incluido papá, o una figura paterna, yo no va a nadie. El mundo actual es muy peligroso, desde luego también es maravilloso, pero considero que más vale prevenir que lamentar. No sé si ha visto ciertas películas y sin afán te asustaría, le nombraré algunas. No las he visto todas, pero sé que hablan del mismo tema, los peligros del mundo. Y recuerde, la realidad supera la ficción. Taken, Lilia Forever, Brokeback Palace, Trade. Ponga atención y si no pueden pagar un viaje para la familia en Europa, vayan a otro país donde el cambio de divisas les favorezca y puedan viajar todos. Suerte. Okay. That was a really long answer for a really short question. So that was the personal opinion of the Confidencias article. It's just an opinion, and I'm not gonna say I'm against or for that opinion, but it's definitely long-winded. The next article we have here is just a short. It's a recetas, chile relleno de pollo al chipotle con salsa de elote. A todos nos gustan los chiles rellenos, pero a veces no se nos agotan las ideas para preparar el relleno. Tenemos esta original receta para ti. Rellena tus chiles con pollo con un ligero picor con el chipotle. Capéalos y salséalos con una exquisita salsa cremosita de elote. Tiempo 10 minutes. Dificultad baja. Proporciones 4. Ingredientes are 2 cucharas de mantequilla, half an onion, cebolla, un diente de ajo, which is one garlic tooth. Dos tazas de pechuga de pollo, 2 cups of, I'm assuming, bouillon. 2 cucharas de chile chipotle en polvo. 1 taza de queso panela, 1 cup. 2 pizzas de sal. 4 chiles poblanos. 1 lata de crema de elote and 4 cucharadas de cacahuete. Instrucciones de preparación. Calienta la margarina en un sartén mediano a fuego medio así. Trona la cebolla con el ajo por 3 minutos. The onion with for 3 minutes. You can put a little salt. Agrega el pollo, y el chile chipotle, the chicken and the chipotle chili. Cocina por 3 minutes, 3 minutes more, together with the onion. Retira del fuego y agrega el queso, mezcla y sazona. Add the cheese. Rellena los chiles con el po pollo y el queso reserva. So you're combining the chicken, the chili, and the cheese. And funde la margarina en una ollita chica a fuego bajo. Agrega la crema de elote. I believe it's elote for corn. So it's corn cream, cream of corn. Una lata de agua. So cream of corn with margarine and cup of water. Cocina por 5 minutos para reducir y espesar un poco. Sirve un chile en un plato, baña con la salsa y agrega un poco de cacahuate encima, which is peanuts. You can add cacahuates. So that's what it comes out to in the end. So chicken with the chili pepper with margarine, garlic, onion, and cream of corn and peanuts and cheese. Okay, so good luck with that. And I forgot to translate the preceding article, which was a mother asking some advice about her daughter. And she was asking that her daughter wants to go to Europe for her sweet 15, I guess, sweet 16. So she wants for her birthday, and she to go with her 18-year-old prima, cousin, and best friend. So the question was, is it okay if I allow my daughter and her cousin to go by themselves to travel in Europe? For, I don't know, they didn't really specify for how long. So maybe a few weeks, I don't know, or a week, they didn't say. And that they can't, you know, they can only afford to send the daughter and maybe the cousin who's a few years older, but they can't afford to take any the whole family or whatnot. But and they said they're gonna have tour guides helping them, whatever, through the travel agency, I guess. But the concern of the person who answered, which was in the article, was that it's not safe and you shouldn't just let two young girls travel in Europe by themselves, because there's all kinds of dangers out there. And since there's not going to be really a parent or any adult figure with them, it might be a problem or whatever. So he recommended having at least one person who's besides just the 18-year-old girl that will go with them, like a chaperone, like a dad, mom, somebody like that, that will go with the two girls to make sure they're safe. That was the recommendation, which is not a bad idea, I guess. They'd have to pay for an extra person ticket to go to Europe. And but everybody has, you know, their own point of view, and that person said if it were my decision, I wouldn't let the young girl go, you know. So she might get kidnapped or whatnot, I don't know. But from my personal point of view, I've been to Europe when I was maybe, what was I, 20? I was on a travel abroad program for 3 weeks, and it was in, the travel abroad was in the summer session to Africa, to South Africa. We stayed 2 weeks in Cape Town, 1 week in Johannesburg, but there was about 26 of us, I believe, and there were two adults teachers that took us. One was Professor Price, who was an older professor, you know, a PhD, I believe, and the other was his assistant, like a master's or a PhD student who was working on his PhD. So the two of them took all of us, and we were all different, from different colleges all around, I believe all around the U.S. So we were 24 of us or something, plus the two teachers, that we went, as a group on the airplane. We made a pit stop in Netherlands, in Amsterdam, on the way there and on the way back. So So I did see some of Europe. I've also been to Rome when I was about 8, coming from the USSR. We were there about a week or two. But yeah, it is a good point that there's cultural differences and language differences, which might cause problems or difficulties. There might be financial issues. They might run out of money, somebody might steal their money, things like that. That they might get stranded and have no way to ask for help or call. So yeah, it is kind of a risky thing if you're going by yourself with like nobody. But if it isn't like a program where they have a guide and they're taking responsibility to some extent, and it's an organized tour, like with a group, I wouldn't really be too concerned about it, because you have people to help you, and you meet people and you're becoming accountable for each other. So anyways, thank you guys. Bye. My page is facebook.com/yozalplay. And it's good to have people, to help each other, whatnot, not be all by yourself. In a new or different, unfamiliar place, that could be a little scary. But if they do know where they're going, where they're gonna stay exactly, so at least the parents have a way to contact them in case they need help, things like that. Okay, bye.